Okay, the new Wing-Surfer 7.2 meter. Got a quick walk around for you. As you can see, it's huge, massive, massive wingtips. And the big Sigma style M leading edge. You're riding the 1240 high aspect wing today on the Hover 110. I'm not expecting to get up. As you can see out there, it is really, really light. But that's what we need to test this guy in, is the really light stuff. So we'll see how it goes. And really give it an accurate bottom end test, because there is very, very little wind out there. It's huge. Probably how big this thing is. It's freezing cold here at the moment. It's like 10 degrees, maybe 9 degrees, and you add wind chill to that. Oh, it's big. What a monster. Definitely different to pump. Just trying to work out where I want my hands to pump it. It's just so big. Again, these little gusts coming across the water, they're near nothing. I mean, there's guys out fishing in this cold morning. It's only got a 3 meter wingspan, which is really cool. So it's not any bigger than the 6 really in wingtip to wingtip, but the physical size of those wingtips, they're huge. Look at it. That's gonna be where the real trick is. Behind me. The hardest thing is getting it back forward again. That wingtip is so big that on the return pump, doesn't want to pull away from you. You nearly end up needing that little bit more wind just to pull the wing away from you. It's definitely going to be a trick to it. Just need a little bit more wind to work it out. Bad my first job. Once you are up, wow, this thing is crazy. Thank you. feet. See if we can get it out of the drill without coming off the foil. No wind. Really just gliding through these lulls, like next to no wind at all. Probably sounds windy because I'm actually going quite fast. I don't know what speed I'm going, but just slowed down now. Super sensitive to oversheeting. From such a big wing at low speed, I guess. Third handle from the front and second from the back. Feels kind of nice, but I am oversheating a little bit every now and then. Absolutely numb now, I cannot feel them at all, I can't feel my fingertips. So I don't know how many more runs I'm gonna do. That was good. Considering how light it is. Now the wind just switched like 45 degrees then. Okay, a little bit of pressure coming up here, but I haven't got much time once I get up. Let's hope it all comes together well. Use this little boat weight if you can. Yep, beautiful. Thank you.
strut.
Look at us flying in.
Wow.
That's the tricky thing, is you're literally flying in nothing. I'm not going to get a turn around in this little wind. Anyway, it's nice and firm, very stiff, like a very direct feel considering how big it is. Obviously the draft moves around a little bit with being so low aspect and so deep. But it is a beast. I really do wish I could feel my hands. So I'm thinking with the pumping, you gotta do a much shallower pump than you can do with the 6 meter. And a lower frequency. If you pump too aggressively in your back, so much of the wing back wings, and it tends to drive that wingtip down towards the water. Which, you know, with a wingtip that big, it's always going to be a challenge keeping it out of the water. But I do still think it'd be preferred over wingspan. I mean, if this thing had a bigger wingspan to try and get the area, man, you definitely wouldn't be able to cruise along like this. Your wing would be in the water. The difference between going and not going is so small. You're mainly just built around how you can pump it. I'm going to try to take off with the third handle this time. Definitely feels nice with a bit of pressure in it for sure. That gusket's great. In saying that, we're talking maybe 8 knots. I'm actually pretty wound. The big wing on tap. Now, that was pretty good for light wind. I'm happy with that. This is a big gust. Wow. So the downside to the big wings, the leash really gets in the way. Oh, you suck. Not sure what it did then. Still getting used to the balance point on the new 110. You nearly got to pump more with your front arm than your back arm.